and the general qualifications are 1. To be with a compassionate heart, and to be fortunate enough to be born in a time when Tao is available to the public. 2. To have sowed the seeds of virtue by helping many people and offering lots of charitable services in the previous lives. This is the divine affinity with God. 3. To have ancestors with beneficences and welfare work as well. 4. To meet the introducer and guarantor who indicate the way to attain Tao to me. It is very likely that, in the previous lives, we did charitable services together, or we self-cultivated together in the same religion. So, in this life, when Tao is available, we can help each other out and practice Tao together again. So time is ripe for Tao due to our divine affinity. D.I. What impact does receiving Dao have on me? As we mentioned before, and like the old days when hermits had to leave their families to receive Tao through meditation and self-cultivation, Tao, at the present time, can be received in a way that is applicable and conforming to our practical needs. We don't have to give up our lifestyle in order to attain Tao. By the grace of God, Tao is intended to be delivered to the public at all levels of occupations and around the world, rather than being limited to a privileged group of people. The impacts that receiving Tao can have on our daily life are summarized as the following. A. Receiving Tao creates no conflicts with any religions. Tao governs the universe, including all human beings. It existed before the formation of any religions. It is concordant with all religions, in the sense that religions preach the awareness of conscience and the pursuit of the truth. We don't need to give up our religion in order to receive Tao. On the contrary, by receiving Tao, we will have further understanding of the truth. The conscience becomes our ultimate guidance due to the variations of cultures, customs, backgrounds, legislation, and value systems. It is difficult to find a universal guideline for all of us to follow in our daily life. In receiving Tao, the main commandment is to act by our conscience, the true self, rather than by literature. We should be sensitive to the conscience, rather than be familiar with the laws. See. We will voluntarily keep the promise made while receiving Tao. Through receiving Tao, we are not offered conscience or true self, but merely the opening of the door to a wisdom and mercy. Therefore, we restore the heavenly principles inherent in us, and strengthen the power originating from our conscience. There is no external force that makes us keep the promises and commitments that we made when we received Tao. The only force comes from the guilty feelings that result from our misbehaviors, which reduces the mistakes we make. Deep practicing Tao can accommodate our worldly affairs. The fulfillment of practicing Tao and conscientious awareness does not have to be accomplished in a temple or church. It is not required to abandon worldly belongings or relationships in order to attain the ultimate truth. Each individual can still have his/her family, career, and schooling at the same time. As long as we keep in mind the basic guideline, we should have our practicing Tao and getting closer to our divine self. We will make a better world by improving ourselves first after we receive Tao, by realizing the true self and what we are. The feeling of joy comes to us. The improvements on the quality of our spiritual life will affect people surrounding us. By interacting and working together in Tao, we will make the world better with lower crime rate and less pollution. The wish of Maitreya will finally come true to turn the world into God's kingdom and make people all live in harmony. D.I.I. What can attest the validity of Tao Tao, due to its completeness and generality, regulates the totality of all beings. Many people, after receiving Tao, with their wisdom, faith, and devotion, realize that Tao is the fundamental principle that governs all things. They comprehend the truth of the universe not only through literature, but also through daily living and nature. Their faith in Tao becomes strengthened and they move forward in their spiritual life. However, for people who haven't or just received Tao, Tao can be confirmed through revelations. Anyone who has received Tao with the front door open shall die peacefully. One proof of this is that for those who have received Tao and died, their bodies remain soft and their faces vivid. Since the soul leaves the body through the correct exit, the corpse can actually remain uncorroded for a few days. With the most advanced modern science and technology, it is still difficult to explain this phenomenon. However, it is a fact that cannot be denied. This has happened before in some religions, but very rarely. For people who have received Tao, this kind of testimony is ubiquitous, unless they have committed serious sins and corrupted their own mind. This can prove the soul has reached an ultimate harmony. Me being the superintendent of the things on earth, human beings are nonetheless weak. Since birth, we are subject to unpredictable accidents and natural disasters. There have been many people who encountered danger, used the three treasures with faith, and got away from the danger or reduced the damage to the minimum. Testimonies of this kind are numerous. The above two mentioned are rarely heard of and difficult to believe, but they are the immediate security given by God once a person has received Tao. Thereafter, with each individual's faith, wisdom, and the accumulation of good deeds, one will come to know the truth more and more. It is up to you to experience the value of this treasure. I hope you will have the opportunity to receive Tao, experience it in your life, achieve ultimate perfection, and realize eternity. Thank you. 3 TRASRUAs of Tao.
三宝心法主讲者五静妙翻译者
Mr. Jerome William McCarthy Index
目录
Chapter 1 Why are they congratulating me on receiving the Tao?
第一章为什么他们恭喜我求得天道
Chapter 2 What is the Tao?
第二章蛇魔是道
Chapter 3 What are the three treasures?
第三章何谓三宝
Chapter 4 Why do the introducer and the sponsor take an oath at the altar?
第四章为什么引宝要立愿
Chapter 5 Why I should take an oath before receiving the Tao?
第五章为什么要力求道愿
Chapter 6 How to save human beings
第六章如何求度众生
Chapter 1 Why are they congratulating me on receiving the Tao Ladies and gentlemen, I would like to extend my heartiest congratulations to you for this is your most auspicious dayToday you have received the Tao which is the ultimate aim of existence. All of the Buddhas and saints attained the Tao in the past and, by transcending the limitations of birth and death, had become immortal. That which you have received today is the same Tao. Formerly,One who intended to receive the Tao had to abandon worldly possessions and enjoyments. If he was a king, he had to abandon his kingdom. If he was a high official, he had to resign his high position, leave his family and go to the remote mountains to seek a master who would transmit the Tao to him.After much suffering he would gradually perfect his conduct, purify his mind and heart and perform many good deeds. For his sincerity, God would send Buddha to transmit the Tao to him. Under such conditions a person able to succeed was hard to find.During that period the Tao was secretly transmitted from one patriarch to another.
第一章为什么他们恭喜我求得天道各位先生太太小姐首先让我衷心地恭喜你们因为今天是你们大喜的日子今天你们得了道道是至宝，道超出了一切。每一位古圣先贤佛祖皆于古代求得天道，故他们能超出生死之界限而永存。今天你们所得的道即同他们其实所得的道一样。在古时人要得到必须弃他在世界上所拥有之一切与享受。假如他是一位皇帝也必须弃他的江山。假如他是一位大他必须舍弃他的爵离开家人入深山寻访能够指点他途径。传授大道给他的名师在他经历了千辛万苦之后同时已将凡心修炼成佛心并已达至圆满之行为以及做了许多善事在他至诚之下终于感动上天之心派仙佛来指点传授大道给他在如此之情况下成功者非常稀少在那时道是由一代祖师秘传给下一代祖师
Today we need not go to the remote mountains in order to cultivate ourselves. We may find the means to do so in our own environment. Therefore we must take full advantage of our fortunate circumstances because we are in close proximity to the Tao. Why is the Tao so accessible to us at this time? It is because mankind is facing great calamities which signal the destruction of the human race. What is the cause of these calamities in this modern age? Most people blindly worship technical science and neglect spiritual harmony. They believe that the power of mankind can surpass nature and that science is almighty and can solve all human problems. It would seem as though conscience or soul are only religious terms and had no real existence. Most people do not recognize their true selves, which are indestructible and immortal. Actually, the true self is the master of the mortal body. Today most people have lost their consciences, harming others in order to benefit themselves. Those evils which human beings are now committing will cause great disasters the likes of which had never been witnessed before. This will be the final calamity in which the human race, the immortals of space, and the ghosts in hell will all be destroyed.
然而现在我们不需要到深山去，而我们亦莫修行，何以我们能如此容易就得到？这是因为时代不同了。现在人类面对劫难之来临，末劫就要来到，末劫将会毁灭全人类。劫难是怎样造成的？原因是在此新世纪，多数的人们共盲目崇拜科学，而不注重心灵的完善。他们相信人类的力量能超出大自然，科学是高于一切，科学是万能，科学能解一切人类之问题。而良心、灵性仅是宗教之名词，它永不能实现。人们不认识真理，真理是我们之良心、道心、真我本体，它不不灭，万不长存，它是主持我一生之主人翁。如今世上的众生大多数失去了真正的良心，他们造一切之罪恶，因此造成了空前绝后之浩劫，我们称它为末劫。在此浩劫中，不仅全世界的众生，同时起天的大仙、地府的鬼魂都要受劫灭。
However, Godof whose essence we are created, is merciful and compassionate and does not desire that the good people be destroyed along with the evil ones. So God has provided that the Tao be disseminated among mankind and has sent the great teachers, Buddha Shikung and Bodhisattva Yue.To rescue the three kinds of beings, the immortals of space, human beings, and the ghosts in hell, so that they may return to heaven together. Buddha Shikung and Bodhisattva Yue are under the command of God and are responsible for transmitting the Tao to the three kinds of beings.Their duty is to manage the work called the Last Salvation. This salvation is formless and soundless, and the transmission is performed without preaching. It directly points out the original nature, conscience, or soul of mankind in order that people may realize their true nature and thereby become enlightened.
然而，是我们灵性的至高无上之母亲上帝，是非常的慈悲，一不忍善恶俱焚。因此降下真道，并派名师济公活佛与月慧菩萨降世，挽救三曹弃天之大仙，世界的众生，地府的鬼魂同返天堂。我们师尊师母二位老大人奉老母的命令，真传真守，普渡三曹。他们的责任是办理末后一收元大事，不立文字，教外别传，直指人心，直指人人固有之良心。灵性是人们见自性而成佛。
When the last calamity arrives, nothing can save mankind except the true way.Which is the Tao sent from God. That is why the Tao is widely propagated today to save good people. Ancient people first cultivated themselves and then received the Tao. But today we receive the Tao first and then cultivate ourselves. Therefore,After we have received the Tao, we have to seriously cultivate ourselves. Then we shall automatically be safe from danger, escape from calamities, avoid reincarnation and become saints and Buddhas.
当末劫临头时，没有任何其他方法可以解救众生。除了上帝所降下的唯一之道，因此现在大道普渡善男信女。古人是先修后的，先修道然后才得道，现在我们是先的后修，因此得道以后，我们要真正修道，将来自然能逢凶化吉，堕劫彼难，超生了死，成圣成佛。
Although it is easier for modern people to receive the Tao than it was for past generations, the ability to receive the Tao also depends on each person's condition and background.Today you receive the Tao because you had an affinity with our temple and your ancestors have performed many virtuous acts. Possibly you were cultivated in a religion in your previous lives. These conditions allow you to have an affinity for the Tao. Without this affinity you would never receive it.
虽然今人比古人更易得到，然而亦是各凭各知根基缘分。今天你们得到皆因与佛有缘，前世有行善积德，祖先有德，也许前世有修过五大宗教或其他宗教，因此使你们今天有缘得到。否则将永不能得到。
Chapter 2 What is the Tao, ladies and gentlemen? You have received the Tao today, but what did you actually receive? What is the Tao? The Tao is the source of everything. Tao is the creator and master of the universe. Tao is God, the supreme power.Before the earth and sky existed, before the creation of the universe, the Tao existed. After the universe is annihilated and nothing remains, the Tao will continue to exist and to create and control a new universe. The Tao is limitless, invisible and formless. It cannot be seen, heard, smelled or touched and is beyond the power of human comprehension. Tao activates everything. Yet we cannot see its action. It works without effort, yet nothing left undone. Man usually calls it nature. Nothing can exist without the Tao because everything depends on it. Tao is God and our soul issues from God's essence. We are God's children.
第二章蛇魔是道各位今天已经得道，究竟的是蛇魔是魔是道道是天地人万物之母，道是宇宙之本源，创造者地及主宰者，道上帝，道至尊至贵之神，当天地还未生之前。 一切都未有之前，道已先存在的。当天地毁灭后，道不毁灭；道能再生天地人万物，天地人万物生成了道其中主宰。道非常奥妙，道无形无相，视而不见，听而不闻，不可嗅，不可捉摸。 道超出了人们的想象力而不思议，亦不可言说，一切皆是道所为。然而我见不到道的动作，道是无为而为的，然一切莫不是道所为。人们常称它为自然。假若无道，任何一物不能存在。 因为一切都依靠道而的存。道上帝，我们之灵性是上帝所赐，我们是上帝之儿女，上帝是我们之天。
When we speak of the creator of the universe, we call it Tao. When we speak of the ruler of everything, we call it natural law. When we speak of the animating and controlling principle of our being, we call it soul or conscience. When we speak of the creator of our soul, we refer to the Heavenly Mother. In Chinese she is called Lao Mu. All and let the above are one and the same.
当我们从它作为宇宙之本源而言, 称它为道，在它作为一切之主宰而言，我们称它为理。当它在我们体内，使我们生存并支配肉体时，我们称它为灵性或良心，因为它赋予我们本性。我们称它为老。 这些名称虽异而其意相同，皆指同一物而言。
Now, what you have actually received is the Tao. Tao is everybody's true self. Today you have been initiated by the teacher and the door of your mind has been opened. Now you are able to understand that the body is not your true self. The body is controlled by the Tao within you.
现在你们的就是道，道是每一个人的真我。今天你们以的名师指点开了心窍，现在你认识了肉体并非真正的你。 而灵性才是真正的你，那位无形无相的。然而，在支配你的身体的灵性， 才是真正的你自己。
While you are alive, your soul dwells within your body. As soon as the soul leaves your body, you are dead. Your soul is from God, but your physical body is from your parents. You already had the Tao within you yet did not realize it. Therefore, you have had to search for it and had now been fortunate enough to find a teacher who was able to transmit it to you. Previously you believed that the physical body was your true self and behaved accordingly. You were selfish, committing misdeeds, acts of violence, and overindulging in physical pleasures. This condition repeatedly led you into a reincarnation and endless sufferings. Now you understand that your true self is not your physical body but only use the body as a vehicle. You are not limited to this physical body. You are boundless. You are the master of the universe because you have God's essence within you. You are full of mercy and love because you share of God's spirit. Most people today have forgotten all these spiritual characteristics and do not know who they really are. Today you are regaining your conscience, your true self.
每个人活时，灵性在他体内，若灵性已离开，他立刻就死亡。灵性附于天，而肉体由父母而来。因此，事实上我们已有道在身上，为何还要再寻求它？还要有点传师来传授？原因是我们已不认识它了。我们以为肉体真我，而不知它原是假，因此我们变得自私，做了许多错事与罪恶。为了持此色身，享受如此，使我们坠入轮回中，遭受无边痛苦。我们不知真正的我乃是灵性，而我们已不是仅限于此肉身。我们是无限的广大，我们是宇宙之主宰。因我们的灵性与老是一体，我们的本性充满了慈悲与爱心，因我们是老之分灵。然而现在人们都失去了这些品性，亦不知他究竟是谁。今天我们得到是的回真我良心。
Chapter 3. What are the three treasures today you have received? The three treasures, A. The heavenly portal B. The divine mantra C. The symbolic seal A. The first treasure, the heavenly portal, the point where the teacher placed his finger upon your face during the ceremony is called the heavenly portal. It is the abode of your true self and can be described in different ways, such as, 1. Original nature. This is the true self, soul, or conscience which is eternal and indestructible. 2. The portal of birth and death. The heavenly portal is the door by which our original nature enters and leaves our body. Confucius asked, who can leave the house without using the door? Why do people not follow this way? 3. The way to heaven. A Buddhist sutra says, heaven is 108,000 miles away. These words are the metaphor which actually means that it was not easy to become enlightened because the true teacher was difficult to find and the Tao was not yet widely propagated. Without the proper understanding of the Tao, heaven seems very far away, but with a real understanding of the Tao, heaven is very near. Today your teacher has pointed out the way for you and you may now ascend to heaven with one step.
第三章，何谓三宝经天？你们所得之至宝，亦可称为三宝：一玄观、二口诀、三合同。以第一宝玄观，玄观玄妙莫测之门。玄观点传师向你们指点之处，它有许多名称，一点本性，此是我本来固有的真我灵性良心，它是不毁不灭的，它永远存在。二点生死之门户，玄观是灵性出入身体之门户。孔子曰：谁能出不由户，何莫由斯道也。三点通天大陆，佛经云：西天十万八千里，此是譬喻，亦成佛是不义之事，因为名师难访，大道还未普传。然而名师经已指点明明路，你一步登天。四点。
The main entrance, the heavenly portal is the main entrance. It is situated at the center and not to the left or right, above or below. This entrance was locked after your imperishable spirit entered the body at birth. If the heavenly portal is not unlocked by your teacher,your true self is not able to leave the body by the main entrance at the time of death. Instead, it will have to leave by one of the side gates, A. The eyes, B. The ears, C. The mouth, D. The nose, E. The navel, F. The vertex. If your spirit leaves from the ears, it is reborn as a viviparous animal, such as a horse, pig, cow, sheep, etc. B. Eyes, it is reborn as an oviparous bird. C. Mouth, it is reborn as a creature of the water, such as a fish, a lobster, etc. D. Nose, it is reborn as an insect, such as a fly, a moth, a bee,etc. E. Navel, it is reborn as an ordinary person. F. Vertex, it is reborn as a wealthy and powerful person. 4.
正门玄关是正门，它正好位于当中，不偏向左也不偏向右，不在上也不在下。当灵性投入身体后，四门关闭了。假如我们不遇名师指开玄关，临终时我们的灵性将无正门可出离身体，它只能由其他旁门出去，眼耳口鼻肚其顶门。如果灵性走旁门，亦由耳而出者，来生当为胎生之动物，如马、猪、牛、羊之类；二由眼而出者，来生当为卵生之动物，如飞鸟之类；三由口而出者，来生当为食生之动物，如鱼虾之类；四由鼻而出者，来生当为化生之动物，如苍蝇、蜜蜂之类。五由肚脐而出者，来生当为平庸之人。六由顶门而出者，来生当为富贵之人。 上述之路乃生死轮回之路，不能脱出生死之苦。点传师点开玄关正门，这是通天之路，我们不必再走四门，不必再坠入轮回受苦。但是我们必须要真修，否则玄关虽开，我们的灵性仍不能返天，因我们还是充满罪恶，灵性为罪恶所是不能自由从正门而出的。五点。
In the Bible Matthew 13:11, John said to his disciples, I baptize you with water to show that you have repented, but that one who will come after me will baptize you with the Holy Spirit and fire. The vow is transmitted to you in the temple of God through God as sanction and commandment. The holy lamp on the altar symbolizes God. In the transmittal ritual, the teacher uses the incense to lead a line of fire from the holy lamp to your heavenly portal. Then, using his finger, he connects God as spirit with your spirit so that they flow together as one, thereby enlightening you with God as spirit. This is the actual fulfillment of John's prophecy. 5.
圣经上记载约翰对他的门徒说，我用水给你们施洗，表明你们已悔改。然而在我之后的将用圣灵与火给你们施洗。请记忆，你们是在上帝的宫殿里得到，因为我们有上帝的天命，那盏佛灯代表上帝老。在点道之仪式中，你们已见到点传师以香柱从佛灯引来一条金指向你们的玄关，然后借点传师的手指点在你们的玄关之时，上帝一一的圣灵已点开了你们的心窍，照破了黑暗。现在你们可见到约翰之预言已经实现在你们身上。
Satyamuni Buddha said, I have the great Dharma which is hidden in the eyes. This indicates the location of the heavenly portal. 6.
释迦牟尼佛云，无有正法掩藏此语，暗示玄关之底。
Be the second treasure, the divine mantra 1.You have now been given the divine mantra. It is very important to remember it as it will save your life. It is only to be used in extremely dangerous situations. This mantra acts as a powerful spiritual distress signal to the divine forces, much like an SOS transmitted by radio waves.It is to be projected mentally and silently with great concentration while at the same time focusing the eyes on the heavenly portal and holding the symbolic seal with the hands. Powerful aid will immediately be sent to you in order to rescue you from danger. If you sincerely cultivate yourself,You will always remain under the refuge of Buddha.
二第二宝口诀，心经或五字真经，一刚才传授口诀给你们，还记得吗？请再说一遍。当性命危险时，你才用此宝，将真经默念口中，手抱合同。你将可被仙佛救护，脱离危险。 不过要注意此口诀仅能于性命为及之时方可运用。假若我们真诚修道，当然我们将首先佛之地有二点。
The divine mantra which connects your true self with God. This mantra is without form, sound or color and is the essence of Tao, the underlying and ultimate principle of the universe. This mantra unites your being with that of the Tao, forming a powerful bond. Every great religion indicates this potential unity, but they do not fully understand how to implement and effect it. You now have this knowledge and are familiar with its application.
二心经，口传心授由声音而达入无声因果之真心，由天经万点而达入真经真点，心经心法真空也，真我本性也。三点。
The true teaching is transmitted from mind to mind. The true self, the I, the spirit, the mind all indicate the true center of man or his real essence and original indestructible nature which is identical with Tao. The human being is a microcosm, sharing all the attributes of the macrocosm. Since he is essentially divine, man only needs to understand the nature of reality and align himself with it. The more pure and refined his nature, the more conscious he becomes of his relationship with the Tao. When he realizes that he is one with the Tao, he has become fully enlightened.
三以心传心口传心手以老之心传于众生之真心，此者老的分灵之心也。
See, the third treasure, the symbolic seal one. In Chinese, ka means to combine and dun means all together. The symbolic seal which is formed by the two hands joined together is the golden seal which is formed by the two hands joined together is the golden seal which unites us with God. It is like a contract or mutual agreement which is the actual meaning of Hatun between you and your heavenly mother. It acts as a signal, password, or passport. It is a spiritual instrument of identification, as well as symbol with many ramifications. 2. When you hold the symbolic seal you are united with God. 3. The left hand is good so it is placed on the outside, covering the right hand. The right hand is often used for evil purposes, such as beating and killing. The right hand is placed on the inside because of its evil propensities and is shielded by the left hand. Together the hands hold the word child which is formed by the two thumbs in proximity symbolizing the Chinese word hai which means child. This hand symbol acts as a direct signal to God. It serves to mobilize heavenly protection and causes the user to escape from any impending calamity. 4. Let us quote some words from the Bible, Matthew 19:13-15. Some people brought children to Jesus for him to place his hands on and to pray for them, but the disciples scolded the people. Jesus said, "Let the children come to me and do not stop them, because the kingdom of heaven belongs to them. He placed his hands on them and then went away. This event illustrates the power and significance of the symbolic seal. At that time Jesus placed his hands on the children's heads and explained that this is the way to God's kingdom. Today we hold the child symbol and realize that we are the children of God and are willing to return to God's presence.
三第三抱和同一点和同之意和是和成一体同是相同和同象征老赐予我们的精印表示我们已归根人我们手抱和同表示我们要与老和成一体同老一样是说与老和灵永不再分开。二点和和同，同同和，抱起和同，能闭眼罗。三点左手属善当在外，右手属恶居内边，子亥相掐怀中抱，能脱九大大劫关。四点现在让我们引用圣经之语句，有一些人带孩子们到耶稣跟前求耶稣为他们按手祝福，但是使徒们责备那些人，耶稣说让孩子们到我这里来，不要阻止他们，因为上帝的国是属于如此的人，耶稣为他们按手祝福然后离开。从这件事我们可以了解他是对和同之一种预言。在那时耶稣把手按在孩子头上并说须如此方能返回天国。如今我们手抱子海觉并觉悟我们是上帝的儿女且愿意回返上帝身边。
Chapter 4 Why do the introducer and the sponsor take an oath at the altar before you receive the bow from your teacher? Two persons take an oath at the altar, one as your introducer and one as your sponsor. Without these two persons, the vow will not be transmitted to you. The introducer vouches for your character and guarantees your good conduct. The sponsor guarantees that the vow is the true path and that the teachings are genuine. A vow is also taken to guarantee that any money which you may donate to the temple will only be used for the printing of books and other such noble purposes.
第四章，为什么银宝要立愿在点诗还未传到给你之前，有两个人做你的银宝师先立愿引导你求道，否则点传师不可传道给你。这两人保证你是好人，并发誓他们是引你入正道，并非左道旁门或邪教。他们并非狂哄你的钱财，否则他们愿受天雷诛。你奉献的功德金是来建佛堂引善书，任何人也不能把它用在私人用途上。
Chapter 5 Why I should take an oath before receiving the Tao. Before anyone receives the Tao, he has to take a vow which states that he will faithfully adhere to the principles of Tao and will not reveal the secret teachings of the three treasures to anybody.
第五章，为什么要力求道认？每个人在为求道前，必须先立愿，表白他将诚心报道及不泄露天机三宝给任何人。
Chapter 6 How to Save Human Beings. Now you have received the Tao which is ineffable, sacred and sublime. You have just been saved by someone, so now you should try your best to spread these exalted teachings to your fellow human beings and urge your family, friends and acquaintances to receive the Tao.This is of great merit for you because you are not only saving someone's physical body from disaster, but you are also saving his true self from the sufferings of reincarnation. Also, you not only save that one person because, if he cultivates himself properly,He can also save seven generations of his offspring by his virtue. How great is your merit?
第六章，如何救度众生？如今你已得了大道至宝，你已被人救度，你也应该去救度别人。所以请你尽量的度你家人亲戚朋友求道，让他们亦得蒙上天之恩典，此乃你莫大之功德。因为你不仅救了他的灵性脱离轮回之苦，并且救他的色身脱离劫难，同时你不仅是救了一人，假若他真修，他将能以他的功德来超拔九玄七祖。你的功德何其大呀！群书志要360第二册，华藏净宗学会公志点。
http://www.mb.tw/rusty/wisdom/wd.ask/web_choice=69。
群书志要360。第二册群书志要许群书志要是唐太宗李世民西元59年649年于贞观初年下令编辑。太宗16岁随父从军，起义平定动乱的社会，戎马孔总十余年。27岁即帝位后，念悟修文，特别留心于治平之道，修生养宁。太宗因武善变，遗憾早年从军，读书不多。鉴于前隋灭亡之师，深知创业不易，守成为奸，在位期间鼓励群臣进谏，批评其决策过失，令谏官魏征及虞世南等整理历代帝王治国资政史料，截取六经四史诸子百家中有关修身齐家治国平天下之精要，汇编成书，上使武帝，下启晋代，自14000多补89000多卷补集中，博采典籍65种，共50余万言。书成如魏征于序文中所说，实为一部用之当今，足以简览前古，传之来也可以一绝孙谋的治世宝典。太宗喜其广博而切要，日日手不释卷，曰：使我击鼓铃是不惑者， 轻等力也。由是而知，贞观之治的太平盛况，此书贡献大已成为从政者必读之宝典。然因当时中国雕版印刷尚未发达，此书至宋初已失传，宋史亦不见记载。所幸者，日本今则文库藏有镰仓时代1921-1933年日本僧人手写群书制药的全志，并于清乾隆60年由日人送回中国本土。上海商务印书馆四部从刊和台湾分别依此版为底本影印出版。21年岁末，净空性的四书反复翻阅，欢喜无量，深刻体会古圣先贤之文化教育的能为全世界带来永恒之安定和平。最极关键者即国人本身必须真正认识传统文化，断以起信。圣贤传统文化实为一切众生自性流露，超越时空，亘古弥新。学其关简端，在诚敬二字。徐礼曰：吾不敬。前清康熙曰：灵明以主敬为本，诚与敬，千古相传之学，不越乎此。程子曰：敬胜百邪。说明修身敬德立世记名，唯诚敬二字方能圆成。若对古圣先王之教育毫无诚敬，纵遍览群集亦难获实意。孔子曰：述而不作，信而好古事也。过去孙中山先生于三民主义讲演中民族主义第四讲曾云：欧洲的科学发达，物质文明的进步，不过是近来200多年的事。讲到政治哲学的真谛，欧洲人还要求之于中国。诸君都知道世界上学问最好的是德国，但是现在德国研究学问的人还要研究中国的哲学，甚至于研究印度的佛理，去补救他们科学之偏。英人汤恩比博士更云：欲解决21世纪的社会问题，唯有孔孟学说与大乘佛法。静观今日世界乱象纷呈，欲救世界救中国，唯有中国传统文化教育能办到。老祖宗流传至今的治国智慧理念方法经验与成效，均是历经千万年考验所累积的宝藏结晶。群书治要治真治贵，我能深解落实，天下太平，个人幸福自然可得。背道而行者，则不免自招灾殃，祸患无穷。净空深知今日群书制药之重现，实有其神圣使命，欢喜委托世界书局重新印出版10000套。密赠两岸三地及世界各国各党各级领导共同学习，则和谐社会大同之治的世界指日可待。新建群书制药重新出版在即， 言出人者主于为序，今以此术语，要随喜赞叹之意。净空21年12月28日于湘江寻书制药36系列序寻书制药乃及中国古圣先王修习治平之智慧方法经验效果视为大成，亦是历经千万年考验所积累下来的文化结晶。这部宝典既能帮助唐太宗开创贞观之治，奠定大唐300年盛世的基础，也必能为当今各阶层领导者提供珍贵借鉴。不仅如此，对于不同领域不同身份的社会大众，此书已如同智慧源泉般，能使身心安乐，家庭幸福，事业永续。本中心导师是净空老教授，念念不忘中华文化的承传。21年底，幸蒙祖宗庇佑，这套宝典最终送到了老教授手中。老人家深知此书是解决当今社会问题的一剂良方，欢喜不已，立即委托世界书局翻印流通。导师在马来西亚拜访纳吉首相与马哈迪前首相时，简略地介绍了寻书制药内容。两位长者当时便迫切地表示想看到英文译本。导师由此想到，可从寻书制药中揭露，选成360条，译成白话文并翻译成各国文字，方便大众每天阅读。导师将这个任务交给了本中心，这就是中心编辑寻书制药36的缘起。导师预计在若干年间，每年从寻书制药当中选取360条原文，并译成各种不同国家的文字语言，在全世界流通。导师认为，这是中国对于整个世界和平做出最大的贡献。制药取材于《金史子》，共计66部50卷，其目录是《江州易》《史记》《六韬》等《金史子》的书目，如此排列。本中心编译之寻书制药36，将整套书概括为六条大纲，均道陈述贵德为正敬慎明辨。每条大纲下又归纳了制药论述的相关要点作为细目，希望本书的纲目对于读者领纳寻书制药全书的精神能有所帮助。寻书制药36的编译工作刚开展，随即得到了中国大陆港台地区及马来西亚本地许多仁人志士的协助，在此一并致上真诚的谢意。由于中心编辑小组的德行学识有限，本书肯定有许多疏漏之处，恳请诸位仁者不吝赐教指正。衷心祝福大众在古圣先贤智慧的引领下，身心和谐，家庭和乐，事业和顺，并希望本书能帮助社会化解冲突，消弭对立， 走向安定、幸福、美满、和平的大同世界。让我们携手并进，共创和谐马来西亚中华文化教育中心。警示2013年3月30日一军道一修身假借贪疑圣人守其所以有不求其所谓得求其所谓得则所有者亡矣修其所有则所欲者至矣卷41淮南自白话圣人安守自己本具的性德而不贪求自己未获得的贪求自己未获得的反而已拥有的会丧失掉因为贪求则无福更有甚者会贪赃枉法将福报折尽如果修养自己本具的性德想得到的就会自然得到因为性德具有无量的智慧德能福报二觉无义之欲以奉德以之徒弃不及之物以修功业之基其余名行弃不善哉卷28无志下注释图宏图银拇指图进门路白话断绝无义的欲望来遵循道德仁义之路放弃无关紧要的事情来修起建功立业的根基这对自己的名声与品性难道不是很有益的吗三福生于无为而患生于多欲不知足然后复从之得宜君人然后贵从之故贵觉而见得者虽为天子不贵矣贪物而不知止者虽有天下不富矣卷八寒诗外传白话幸福产生于内心知足而无所外求而忧患产生于人的欲望过多所以一个人知道满足然后富裕会随着到来得行事和领导民众然后尊贵就会随之而来所以看重爵位而轻视德行的人虽然做了天子也并不高贵贪求财物而不知羞耻的人虽然拥有天下也并不富足四有意欲多亡者未有意无欲为者也有意欲治而乱者未有一首长诗者也卷41淮南自注释常常规常道白话有因为欲望太多而灭亡的没有因为无欲而陷入危险的有因为想要治理却混乱的没有因为遵循常道却失败的五三代之兴无不益损情欲三己之衰无不似其始迷卷29晋书上注释三代指夏商周三己指夏商周三代的末期白话夏商周三代之所以兴盛无不是因为领导者对自己的七情五欲加以节制三代末期的衰败无不因肆意奢侈浪费六日月欲明浮云盖之河水欲清沙石毁之人性欲平事欲害之甫纵欲而失性动未尝正也。 以治乡则师，以治国则败。卷四十一淮南子著是会污染玷污。白话日月本欲明亮，却有浮云遮蔽它。河水本欲清澈，却有沙石污染它。人性本欲宁静，却有事欲妨害它。如果放纵欲望而丧失了本性，那么行动就没有正确的时候。以这种心态修身，则自身会陷入危殆；以这种心态治国，则会使国家衰败。欺天下之愚，莫过于斯，知贪前之利，不睹其后之患也。卷十二五月春秋白话，天下没有比这更愚蠢的了，只贪图眼前的利益，而看不到身后的祸患。巴金人之所以犯淋雨之罪，而陷于行路之患者，由是欲无眼，不修度量之故也。卷四十一淮南子著是淋雨监狱，行路受刑罚或被处死。厌满足度量法度，白话人们之所以犯监禁之罪而遭刑罚杀戮之祸，是因为其嗜欲没有止境，心灵堕落而不以法度自我要求的缘故。